emergency assessment should be taken into account. And the coagulation assays used for them are the common ones, prothrombin time, INR and APTT, and there are still some assays in development. The differentiation of the newer anticoagulants are here, where is the site of action, then the thrombin generation inhibition, the anti-TNA is strong, while here is relatively weaker. The regulatory functions of the thrombin are not compromised, while here is compromised. There is bleeding potential, moderate in the anti-TNA and higher in the anti-2A. And the myocardial infarction signal, which has been mentioned by Professor Nicolaidis and reported in two fatal cases, while we have for the rivaroxaban and the others have not heard anything. The future of the warfarin. It's still in circulation. Many people use it. And we should not forget of its excellent efficacy, the low cost, the centralized anticoagulation clinics that maintain good monitoring, they're still using it. There are prothrombin time assays to test it, and the INR is validated regarding the bleeding risk. It's point of care testing, and there is rapid turnout genetic testing for it. In conclusion, the new oral anticoagulants are different from the conventional oral anticoagulants. The anti-TNA drugs are different from the anti-2A drugs. The differences between anti-TNA and anti-2A are significant and may impact thrombin's regulatory function. Long-term administration may exhibit different safety and efficacy profiles. Currently, we do not have enough data for that. And post-approval surveillance and the registry for the clinical outcome are warranted. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Dr. Carol.